Hey everyone, I'm out here in the garage, and what we're gonna be doing today is fixing my Harbor Freight palm nailer. So stay tuned. So if you're new to the channel, I just wanna welcome you here, and hopefully you'll consider subscribing if you like what you see. Also, check out DIY Apprentice on Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook. I post lots of pictures and videos on those platforms before I post anything on YouTube. And occasionally I'll post things on those platforms I don't post on YouTube. Also, check out the website at DIYApprentice.com. And don't forget to hit the like button if you like this video. So this Harbor Freight palm nailer I bought about 8 or 9 years ago, I believe. And I got about 2 years of use out of it before it started to leak air. And I just kind of set it aside and I just picked up this one here, which is a mini palm nailer by Porter Cable. Now, the problem with this small palm nailer is that it cannot shoot nails that are larger than about 12 penny. So when you start getting in the 16 penny nails, which is what I'm going to have to shoot if I start doing some work in this garage, you can't use this particular palm nailer here. So I decided, instead of buying a brand new palm nailer, to try to fix this one that I've had sitting in the drawer for probably about 6 years now. So, let's get into it. All right, so here's the palm nailer connected to air. So we'll take it apart and see what we find. We'll start by unscrewing the nose piece. There's a spring and a metal washer behind the nose, so be careful to not lose them. Next, we'll remove the four hex head screws from the back using a 5/32 hex key. Then we'll remove the back cover. There are several O-rings in the assembly. One or more are likely the sources of our leak. We'll continue to disassemble the nailer, keeping in mind the orientation of the components. I called Harbor Freight's customer service and was told that there is no rebuild kit for this nailer. Thankfully, the owner's manual includes the O-ring sizes, so I did some searching online using the Google machine. I wanted to stay under $20 to fix this issue, or I would just buy a new nailer. I looked up the components for a popular model such as the Rigid R350 PNA. The Rigid's parts listing on ereplacements.com showed that every O-ring, with the exception of part number 8 in the Harbor Freight manual, was a match. I believe number 11 is M43x2.65 instead of M43x0.65, which I did not buy right away. As a side note, the M size is the O-ring's inside diameter and the second number is the cross section, or basically the O-ring's thickness. Some sites list the O-rings by inside diameter and outside diameter. As an example, an M46x2 O-ring might be listed as 46 millimeters inside diameter and 50 millimeters outside diameter. By the way, I was able to find the M46x2 O-ring on Amazon. So here are all the O-rings I purchased laid out.
079019001017. 07901900.
0190010006. 46 millimeter inside diameter, 2 millimeter cross section. Haven't found. Diagram incorrect for this one. Going to replace this one and this one first and see if that fixes our problem. Pick tool. There we go. Let's pull it out. So there's this one. This is the replacement. Pretty close to the same. Take a little oil off of here. Okay, start it in the groove and just kind of work it around. There we go. That's in. Okay, I'm going to work on this one next. Let's take it out first. Try to be careful just in case I need to reuse it. Pretty much the same. Put it in the groove. Just work it around. And that's in there. All right, so I'm going to give that a shot, see if that fixes it. I do have one more for, I think it's this one here. I just want to kind of eliminate, try to figure out which one caused the problem, if any of them. So I'm going to leave this one for last. All right, I'm going to put this back together now. So this ring goes on like that. This goes on with the O-ring like this. And we'll put this back in. Like that. Back cover on. Like so. Put our screws on. Five 30 seconds. Okay, we'll tighten this down. Let's put our nose piece back on. Got this little washer here. Spring. Nose piece. Make sure that's in the groove there. And we'll grab our wrench. Okay, it's all back together. We're going to give this a shot, see if it worked. All right, so on the compressor, I'm at about 90 PSI. Go ahead and hook this up. That doesn't seem to have worked. All right, so I guess our last bullet in the chamber, so to speak, is this one here. I don't have the other two that are part of this whole set. So I'm gonna pull this one off, see if maybe this one caused a problem. It is a little skinny. So I'm hoping that maybe it got flattened out a little bit too much and kind of wore away. It actually feels a little thinner. See that there? So we're going to give this one a shot. See if that fixes it. Don't know. Yeah, it fits different too. All right. So I'm just going to go ahead and put everything back together. You've already seen me do this, and we'll see how it works. All right, let's give this a shot, see if that worked. Wow, look at that. No air escaping this time. That's pretty cool. So it looks like this is working. I'm going to give this a shot with some nails and see if it works. And so far, I don't hear any air escaping or anything else, so I think that was it. All right, so I've got a couple blocks of wood. We're going to try to nail this in here and see what happens. Wow. So surprisingly, this is actually working again. Looks like we solved our problem. All right, so there you have it. There's repairing the Harbor Freight palm nailer. And as you saw, the main culprit here was that M46x2 O-ring. That one actually comes in a kit of 10. So if you buy those on Amazon, you get a package of 10 of those. So you can just keep changing those out if you ever have issues in the future. But I think this one's going to hold up pretty well. So I don't know exactly what happened with the original, why it failed so quickly. But I think we'll get some life out of this new one. So hopefully this information was helpful. And thanks for watching.